till I can't no more.
I got the horses in the back. Horse stock is
attached. I am Dinka. Hope you are safe and fine wherever you are in this planet. And in this video, I'm going to show you, the review of season 7 and 8, because season 9 is delayed. So let's get started from season 7. In season 7, let's start from battle pass weapons. Look, the special gun in the new gun in season 7 is QQ9, right? Like SMG. Yeah, this is the epic variant. If you are a battle pass player, this is a gun to use because it has a special perk called double kills instantly and bullets into the clip. I don't know why it's useful, even though it adds bullets. This is a gun which you need to use a vulture pack. And if you are if you are not a pay user, you have a raw version of it, and it's still better gun. But because the perk which legendary gun and epic guns are having is useless. As of now, I can't show you the range to kill because in season and everything is changing. And though I tested all the time to kill in previous video. If you haven't seen that video, I'll be leaving in the cards. And apart from this gun, and we have like RUS and AK-117, which are very popular guns from the past. This is the RUS, having the same useless perk. And 117 Bandit. Is it correct, Bandit? And I couldn't find this gun anywhere. Look, I wish they could bring in a cleaner UI such that we can easily search our guns. Barricade, sorry, yeah. Which increases weapon firing range. This is very good perk, but the iron sight doesn't feel good, guys. And the most epic weapon in season 7 is M4, and I also posted an M4 video, the best class setup. You can watch that, I'll leave it in the cards. Okay guys, this gun had a buff which improved the firing range, and this particular gun increases the weapon firing range, but still it lacks from many guns, guys. It's good gun, but the long range is very good, very easy to kill in long range, but it doesn't deliver exactly what we wanted to deliver. And I don't see myself or anybody using this gun in legendary rank, and I particularly feel that it's not a weapon which win matches. If you are a pro player, you can, obviously. If you watch my live streams and stuff, you know I'm not that good player. And in season 7, I also purchased KN44. Look, all the things I am saying, only the paid weapons, such that you can have an idea how it feels like using paid weapons and legendary weapons. Look, I purchased this particular gun for 560 or 540 quad points, just because it increases weapon firing range, because the credit gun doesn't have that perk, and I want that perk. Let me show you the gun. Look, it briefly increases the movement speed when you die, like when you respawn, but I don't want that, so I bought this. And let me show you. yeah, I got this gun and I paid 560 quad points for this. And you know what they did? They released the exact same gun, changing the color, with the same perk. I don't understand why. I'll get into this in a minute, but that's a good thing for you if you didn't buy this, and if you are unlucky like me and you are lucky in season 8 battle pass. And after that, you know, this 220 card points for this battle pass, I spent 560 for this. And coming under legendary guns, the first lucky draw is PW57 Toxic Waste. Guys, this is a good gun. I used this gun in season 4, season 5, season 6. So I bought this, but I don't know why. I personally feel, the normal epic guns are good. Look, I played with this gun like hundreds of matches, and I personally feel this gun is good compared with legendary weapon. I don't know, it's just me. I couldn't play well with this gun, maybe because of iron sight, I think. I don't know, guys, it doesn't feel good for me, it's just me. And the attachments I'm using is quick draw foregrip and stock, though I'm lacking of right aim on this weapon. I wish I had a gameplay with this, but it is what it is, guys. The second lucky draw is AK-117. By far, this is the best gun they released in season 7, because this gun led me to legendary. This gun delivered exactly what I wanted. I overpowered Corded users, I overpowered KN users, I overpowered QQN users with this gun. It also has weapon firing range increases, the special perk. I personally feel that's the only good perk a gun can have, the best perk the gun can have. And guys, this is the best AK-117 skin. Maybe the best skin a gun can have in entire COD Mobile history. Yeah. And you need to buy like 4,900 COD points for React to Cameo skins. And the attachments I use for this gun is quick draw, sorry, foregrip, and second one is quick draw, and third one I may use suspensor or stock. Like I'm the guy who reloads for every bullet, so I'm the one, as I said, I will reload every time, and I shoot always, so I definitely need vulture pack for this. So coming under third gun, which is chopper, I don't know why I bought this, I don't know why I purchased it, but this gun doesn't worth money. I don't know, it lacks a foregrip, it doesn't have a foregrip, I don't, according to my gameplay, my game style, this gun doesn't match me, but I don't regret buying this. I think I played only 3-4 matches with this gun, and which I lost anyway, but I registered many kills, so many kills, like 33 or 34 in domination and hardpoint. Yeah, that's all. But all the LMGs are getting a buff in season 9, so you can expect a video, a dedicated video on this gun. So that's up for season 7. And also we have two skins, everybody knows what are those skins. Yeah, these two, but I never use skins, I only use this girl, Archery. Coming under season 8, if you see the battle pass, you see this these skins, guys, hit view. Yeah, this one, Living Rust, this gun, KN44, HG40, guys, this the same exact guns. First they released in bundles, and then they released there is KN44 HG40 in no the first sorry the first they released in crates. After that they released KN44 HG40 smoke grenade something in a bundle, so I bought it. Now the exact thing they released it for 220 card points in battle pass. Such an unlucky guy I am, right? And if you are lucky, if you bought all this many things for 220, I see many people spending having 70 pulls. Some say they have 100 pulls for getting those all weapons. But yeah, you are lucky if you didn't buy them. So in season 8, they added 4 skins, which is a good change. Thumbs up for them. 4 characters, which after seeing this, my friends, 6 people bought the new battle pass for just so that they are having 4 characters and the epic skins, you know, which they released in crates and bundles. I don't know how people feel who bought in crates especially. So do remember where you are buying in crates and bundles, they will end up having in in battle pass. Okay, and the new gun, the special gun in season 8 is DRH. This is the raw version where you can get for free, which doesn't have any perks. But if you are a battle pass player at tier 50, you have a special perk, increases reload speed. Increases weapon firing range. And if you have a right attachment for this gun, you can have a 3-shot kill. Let me show you. But guys, the best class setup for this gun is this foregrip, quick draw, and OTM. Look, this is a 3-shot kill. If you have OTM, the raw, the basic bullets, the max and capacity of this gun is 20. If you do the math correctly, it kills 3 people at a time. It's a triple kill gun. And why do you need extra mag? As I said, if you are a player who reloads every time, even though you shot one bullet, if you reload, then you don't need extra mag. It definitely need a vulture pack. Without vulture pack, you can't play with this gun. Why do you need extra mag? I don't understand all the players, all the big YouTubers, big brains are saying they need extra mag. Why? I don't understand. And and if you see the AK-117 kit bag, I didn't review it. I didn't play with this gun at all because I have a legendary gun. Why would I use this? But I will be I will be testing in season 9. Maybe I will try to show you as many guns as I can. Guys, don't trust people who are playing in tabs, especially Mac. No, especially in Apple tablets. Look, the Apple has 120Hz refresh rate and 240Hz touch sample rate, which means for them it's easy to move. For them that will be easy for them to move, like movements and all. They have wider screens, so don't trust them. Trust me, I'm playing this in mobile with two hands, two thumbs, and these are my loadouts. Okay, and the first lucky draw in season 8 is RPD Joker, and I don't know why I purchased it. Let me show you. RPD Practical Joker it is. It doesn't have any perks which helps to improve. It just doesn't reveal the victim location, which only used in Search and Destroy. If you use this Search and Destroy, you lost your movement. I don't know why you use it, but after playing with RPD Orbit, the iron sight it's having, I feel like why I bought this gun. RPD Orbit is still the best gun. It has the best iron sight any gun can have. So even Mirage, even this is a paid gun, this iron sight is also good, even though it's not a unique thing. But you know, the only complaint with this gun is it has a separate firing animation when you shoot. look here, and sometimes it was blocking. Look, sometimes it was blocking the enemy location, guys, the movements. If your enemy moves or prones very quickly, you can't shoot with this. You definitely need in sight optics for this gun. That's the only mistake. I think that's a mistake to them. It's just me again. The only problem with me is the iron sight and the animation. And if you know me, I'm not that good player. Even though you have an YT tag in your name, that doesn't mean he's a pro player like me. I am not a good player at all. Note that. And the second Royals QQ9. This is the best gun in season 8. The best lucky draw they have ever released. This is a buttery smooth, guys. So good. I registered my highest skills with this gun. As you can see, I'm using these 3 attachments. Trust me, this is the best attachment you can have. With this, but the perk, I don't like it. Double instantly add bullets into clip. That's not useful. But this is also a weapon where you must have a vulture pack, because it's very short. If you watch my live streams and videos, I already uploaded a video about QQ9 in season 9 beta, where having these 3 attachments and an extended mag, you will get 45 magazine and total of 180 bullets, which is so god. This will be the OP gun in season 9, guys, trust me. If you didn't buy it, try it. This is the best gun a money can have, you can buy in season 8. And I didn't buy in this QQ9. I don't like these colors and all, so I didn't buy. I decided not to buy any lucky draws. I'll only buy reaction cam use draws from now. And also, guys, I bought ASM10. I thought to make a dedicated video about it, but you know, everything is changing in season 9, so I am waiting. After releasing season 9, I will be covering this gun. If you didn't buy it, you can buy it, because this gun is so good. Even in close range, even in long range, we can tap kill everybody. Even the animation, the thunder thing, shows up in multiplayer as well. We'll have a very unique experience with this gun. So that's all for this video, guys. There's nothing much to say. And season 9 may come in August 11th or 12th. That's what we say in monthly calendar. If you go here, event time. So that's all. If you like what you see in this video, or if you want me to improve anything, do consider subscribing. Take care. Bye.